Yes, hello, this is Riley speaking. Who's this? Tech news? An abstract concept that has taken corporeal form such as that it is now capable of making a phone call? Wow. And you called me first?
Everyone's getting excited about NVIDIA's GeForce RTX graphics cards, but there's actually some other pretty cool news about them. An intrepid Reddit user has managed to get FreeSync, AMD's adaptive refresh rate technology, running on an NVIDIA GeForce GPU, specifically a GTX 1060. Now, it's a bit of a complicated workaround, and they kind of cheated, as the method described requires an AMD APU with Radeon graphics. Basically, you plug your GeForce GPU into a regular monitor and run a display cable from your motherboard to the FreeSync monitor, and then select your graphics card as the output. Wow. It's a glimpse at a world where you don't have to choose between two technologies that do the same thing, but are kept apart by overbearing families when all they want to do is just love each other.
Why can't parents ever understand?
I don't know. Parents are the worst.
I hate school.
Check out the news sources in the description if you want the full details on how this unholy union was achieved. So we're right on September's doorstep, which usually means a new iPhone launch, and this year should be no different.
Woo!
Yes! You're excited about that? Apple is going all in on the design philosophy of the iPhone X, as the company is set to release three iPhones with a similar design, meaning you'll see devices with minimal bezels, no home button, and probably the notch that you know and tolerate. Reports indicate that all three models will include Face ID, and the highest end version will have a 6.5 inch screen, making it the biggest iPhone ever, as well as probably giving other smartphones a feeling of inadequacy. Meanwhile, the lowest end model will get a downgrade to a standard LED screen, making it more affordable, but seeing as Apple isn't expected to lower prices too much, you'll probably still have to cough up half a kidney. It's not a whole kidney. But if you can save at least part of your kidney, you should. I'm confused. Since when can you pay for things in kidneys?
Throw in the stones and you got a deal.
Ugh, they're disgusting. I don't want to think about that. And I wanted to ignore all these leaks for as long as possible, but they're getting a bit overwhelming now. We now have a possible launch date for Google's Pixel 3 and 3 XL, October 9th.
Woo!
Yes! Which means it would come right on the heels of the new iPhones expected to appear in September that we just talked about. If you really can't wait until then to have a look at it, an electronics store from Russia has posted a high-resolution unboxing video to YouTube that gives a much better idea of what to expect than previous leaks. A different Russian blogger also uploaded some pictures he apparently took with a phone to Instagram if you're curious what kind of photo quality to expect. Brandon? And yet another person uploaded some images of the device after saying they found the Pixel inside of a taxi cab. I'm starting to think this phone is the worst kept secret since we found out that pro wrestling was fake. Whoa, 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 whoa!
You shut it!
Pro wrestling is what?
You shut your silly mouth.
Oh, you think it's real. I was trying to be like, I think it's
real. Oh, I know it's real!
Oh, jeez, it's, wake up, man! And now it's time for Quick Bits, brought to you by Synergy. If you're an IT professional or a power user who uses two or more computers at the same time that run a different operating system on each computer, like Windows, Linux, or macOS, you could have a severe mouse and keyboard problem. But instead of getting confused, frustrated, and angry, tell you what you should do. Get Synergy. It's a software download that combines your desktop computers together into one cohesive system. Run a single keyboard and mouse across multiple computers seamlessly so you can stop juggling mice and get back to work, you lazy bum. You got no excuses now, so click the link below to learn more. Now on to the clickbaits. That leaked Xbox All Access subscription plan we talked about on Friday is leaked no more, as Microsoft has officially unveiled it. The details are basically all accurate. $22 US a month gets you an Xbox One S, $35 a month gets you an Xbox One X, and both of those plans gets you 2 years of Xbox Game Pass and Xbox Live Gold. But what's new is that the financing is powered by Dell Preferred Account. Microsoft didn't have the means to figure this out themselves. They had to go to Dell, like Dell is the big expert on financing.
You're getting a Dell. An Xbox Dell.
I want an Xbox Dell. Wait, Dell Xbox, it would be Dell Xbox. If you're in the market for a cheap Threadripper, you can now find one for just $300, if you're willing to settle for a first gen model. AMD has slashed the prices of OG Threadrippers in a used car style, everything must go sale, before the second gen SKUs are released to the public, with the 8-core, 16-thread variant being the cheapest, but not the cheapest in my heart. Still love those little guys, they're cute. Intel's new 9th-gen CPUs are just around the corner, and it looks like they may be pretty good overclockers if a leaked benchmark is to be believed. A Chinese tech site has posted a screenshot of an i7-9700K overclocked to 5.5 gigahertz with water cooling instead of liquid nitrogen. Although the alleged overclocker did have to crank the voltage up to 1.563, so temper your expectations for pushing your new CPU this hard every day. It's only human, you know? If you live in Seattle, it just got even easier to minimize pesky human interaction. Oh, I hate that. As Amazon has opened up another Amazon Go location in the downtown area. It's a bit smaller than the original location and has more limited hours, seemingly for 9-to-5 workers that just need to go grab a quick lunch or a box of Tylenol to stave off the dull headaches that come with existing inside a cubicle. Didn't know that was a thing. However, there's no word yet on exactly when the stores will be expanding outside the Emerald City. Is Seattle the Emerald City? Why is it Emerald?
Because you're jealous.
Who's it jealous of? All the other cooler cities. Oh no, I like Seattle, I love Seattle. Starbucks.
Am I right? Starbucks, anyone?
Hey! Facebook continues to try and figure out how to strike a balance between free expression and combating hateful behavior, as the social media site recently banned a number of accounts connected to high-level military figures in Myanmar, who have been widely accused of extremely serious human rights violations within the country. The pages had millions of followers, and the company has admitted it was too slow to do anything about the issue, especially as Zuck really doesn't need another black eye right now. Yeah, I gave him the first one.
He's only got two eyes.
Yeah, if two black eyes, then you're done, man, it's over. And it's now a little easier to see how much time you waste on YouTube, as the account menu will now give you total watch time by day and by week. You'll also have an option to auto-remind yourself to take a break from the screen if you've been spending way too many hours watching inferior, non-tech-link channels. I don't want to say that. I mean, we're okay, but we're not. John wrote that. Guys, that's it for TechLink. It's over. There's no more tech news, ever. This is the end of it. No more. Thanks for watching. It's been good. It's been good while it lasted. Subscribe. I don't know why you would subscribe, because there's no more tech news. But do it anyways, just to make me happy, and James. Brandon, how do you feel about it?
Oh, it's great.
Yeah.
Goodbye news.
Brandon's cool all the time. He's
history
good with whatever.
History.
We talk about the things that passed. I'm talking too long. See you next time.